All right, let's go through these. So picking good algorithms, obviously this is the most important level of optimization. And when sorting a large random list, an order in log in algorithm like merge sort is just intrinsically going to be faster than an order in squared algorithm like insertion sort. And clearly this is a case of choosing the right algorithm. And you know, much of performance CPU programming relies on making efficient use of the cache. This is sort of the number one thing to keep in mind when you're trying to write efficient CPU code, is that there's this big cache hierarchy and you want to write code that's going to make good use of it. And so I would consider this an example of optimization level two, right? It's a basic principle of efficiency on a CPU. On the other hand, blocking for the L1 cache, which means carefully sizing your working set to fit exactly in the per core cache on the CPU, this is a detailed optimization. It's going to depend on the exact CPU model you're using, because every CPU core has a different size L1 cache. I would also put the use of vector registers like SSE or AVX intrinsics into this category, right? These are, not every CPU has SSE. Some have AVX. Some don't have either. So the use of vector registers, the choice of blocking for the L1 cache, cache blocking, I would consider these architecture-specific detailed optimizations. So these kind of architecture-specific optimizations tend to be the domain of what I call ninja programmers. And we'll also touch on a few ninja-style GPU topics like shared memory bank conflicts. I'll try to highlight these ninja topics with this little icon here. The idea is that these are really, you know, not needed or necessarily accessible to every programmer. They tend to be when you're sort of squabbling over the last few percent of optimizations, the last few percent of speed up. I think this is one of the big differences between CPU and GPU programming. On the CPU, these sort of ninja level optimizations can make a really big difference. For example, if you ignore the existence of SSE registers or AVX registers on really modern processors, then you're only getting a fourth or an eighth of the power of each core on your CPU. So you're taking a huge hit in potential performance. On the GPU, for the most part, as a rule of thumb, the speedups to be gained by these sort of ninja optimizations are usually comparatively minor, okay? So we're talking more like a 30% or an 80% speedup by using some of the techniques that we'll talk about with this little ninja icon versus the speedups that you might hope to get from just picking the right algorithm in the first place or, you know, just obeying the basic principles of efficiency on a GPU, such as coalescing your global memory accesses. These can also often make a difference of three times, 10 times, sometimes more. So these, you know, just doing a good job of these sort of higher level principles of optimization matters more on the GPU, and the ninja level optimizations definitely help. Sometimes you can get a speed up here, but it's not a sort of vital step to extract maximum performance the way that it is on a CPU, where if you don't start doing something to make sure you're using your vector registers, you're going to take a huge hit in terms of the efficiency that you get out of your modern CPU. And finally, this last one is, I really just threw that in there for fun. Clearly, shifting a floating point number, casting it to a float and subtracting it from this magic constant is firmly in the category of micro-optimization at the sort of bit-twiddling instruction level. This is an infamous hack that's been used in many places, most famously in the video game Quake 3. And if you're curious, go to Wikipedia and look up fast inverse square root. Of course, these are firmly in the ninja category, and we won't be talking about them at all over today or in the rest of the course.